On May 25, 2022, an earthquake swarm began underneath a little-known volcanic complex on the border of Colombia and Ecuador. By 6 days later, more than 400 daily volcano-tectonic earthquakes were occurring at the Chiles-Cerro Negro complex, and this figure is still continuing to increase. These quakes were centered on the southern flank of the Chiles stratovolcano, which has not produced an eruption in 160,000 years. Specifically, these quakes are centered adjacent to a series of hot springs within a volcanic crater, hinting that if an eruption was to eventually occur, this spot would represent the most likely site. The several thousand volcano tectonic earthquakes which have occurred so far are caused by rock fractures related to the internal pressure of the volcano. Magma moves at depth, pressure builds in a specific spot, and is subsequently released by an earthquake. Despite the rapid increase in seismicity, the alert level of this volcanic complex remains at yellow. Although notable, the ongoing earthquake swarm is so far less energetic than two other quake swarms in 2013 and 2018. These quakes are largely centered at 4 to 6 kilometers depth, while an underlying body of magma is known to exist at 13 kilometers depth. The Chiles-Cerro Negro volcano is located on the border of Colombia and Ecuador, where it is 25 kilometers west of the city of Tolkien. As the name of this complex implies, this system consists of two highly eroded stratovolcanoes which contain collapse scars due to hydrothermal alteration, Cerro Negro de Mayascar to the west and Volcán Chiles to the east. The first of the two volcanoes to form was Cerro Negro de Mayascar, which erupted an explosive mixture of andesite and dacite lava flows interspersed with large volumes of ash. This eruptive activity lasted from 1.4 million years ago until around 200,000 years ago, constructing a very large volcanic cone. Subsequently, Volcán Chiles became active around 510,000 years ago, constructing a large stratovolcano out of eruptions which were surprisingly ash poor, consisting mainly of voluminous lobes of andesite and dacite lava. Although its last eruption was dated to 160,000 years ago, there is a large dacite lava lobe on its eastern flank which appears to be far younger due to its morphology and lack of erosional features. Despite a young-looking ash deposit on Chiles and potentially unreliable reports of a phreatic eruption here in 1936, I do not think that this volcano has erupted in many tens of thousands of years. Regardless of whether this volcano has erupted in that time span, it continues to produce heated acidic hot springs, fumaroles, earthquakes, and release of sulfur dioxide gas. Clearly, there is a large body of magma at depth, but we do not know the size of this magma chamber. I suspect that a truly massive magma reservoir is present, perhaps on the order of at least several dozen cubic kilometers of material. I am basing this assumption on the number of earthquakes alongside the amount and area of magmatic uplift this complex has produced in the last decade. It bears a clear resemblance to large-volume silicic systems such as the Campi Flegrei supervolcano in Italy and the Clear Lake volcano in California, and this is truly worrying. Although not always true, generally speaking, the longer a volcano goes without erupting, and the larger a magma chamber it has, the more voluminous and destructive its eventual eruptions are. What is most worrying relates to the nature of ongoing magmatic uplift. Between 2014 and 2019, a large swath of ground with two clear epicenters was uplifted by 7.5 centimeters near the hot springs where the current earthquake swarms are, and 10 centimeters at a location 9 kilometers to the southeast. This uplift is incredibly broad, suggesting that whatever magmatic system is feeding this complex spans an area of as much as 350 square kilometers. Due to the lack of verifiable information on this volcano, I cannot say what the odds of a new volcanic eruption are. With this being said, if an eruption was to occur, it would most likely begin on Cerro Negro's southern flank and be highly explosive, resulting in pyroclastic flows which could reach up to 13 kilometers distant, along with damaging lahars along riverbeds which could severely damage three nearby cities. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Frozen for supporting this channel.